In this video, I will be setting up and reviewing the Samsung Ultra HD 4K monitor. This is a 32-inch monitor, and the model is UJ59. So let's unbox it. These are the inputs, outputs of the monitor. This is here the power input. This is the 3.5 millimeter jack for audio, display, HDMI and HDMI. So it comes with an HDMI cable only. It doesn't come with a display port cable, which is a shame. This is the neck and this is the base. So to put the base in place, just put it like that. And you need to slide it in like that, and this is it in place. Of course, this one here, it's very easy. So it has a screw here, so put it like this and just tighten the screw. It has some also anti-slip rubbers here, which is good. So here's the screen. Let me remove the protection. So let me install it now and set it up. So I hooked it to HDMI 2 because the HDMI 2 input can go up to 60 Hertz, whereas the HDMI 1 input can go up only to 30 Hertz. So HDMI 2, it is hooked to HDMI 2 and this is the display. Let me switch to screen recording now and show you first how it shows in Windows for the first time and how to install the driver from the Samsung website. So let's check the refresh rate to see how the monitor was identified by Windows. Advanced display settings. It is running at 60 Hertz, which is great. And it detected the monitor. Let me see the driver now. So let's go to Device Manager. So it is detected as a generic monitor here. Let me try to force an update. So it didn't update. So we need to go to Samsung's website to download the driver. So open your web browser and then go to samsung.com. And here in samsung.com, hover over computing and then choose monitors, UHD, WQHD monitors. And then select the monitor. It's a little bit at the bottom, so it is this one. Click on it, and then here click on support, and click on see more content. And here you need to click on device install, the download button under device install. Here it is, and the driver will be downloaded. So once it is downloaded, click on it to open it and to install it, and click yes. And this is the installation. It shouldn't take long. So it will ask you first to choose your GPU. Here I'm gonna choose my GT1030. And it will ask you also to choose to which port you connected the monitor. Here I'm gonna choose HDMI 2 because this is the port I used, and then click on OK. And it will tell you that the driver is successfully installed. So let's check it in Device Manager now. Open Device Manager once again. And let's go to monitors, and you see now it is detected under Device Manager monitors as a Samsung monitor. Let's go now to the menu configuration of the monitor, and I'm gonna show you the best configuration that I found that is to my liking. Of course, choose the configuration that is adequate for your usage and that you like. To go to the menu, you have a rocker switch on the right corner of the monitor. Just press it in. And then it goes left, right, up and down. This is how you navigate the menu. And you make the selection by pressing on the rocker switch. On top of accessing the menu, the rocker switch also functions as a shortcut for volume and for some basic picture settings. So let's start now with the configuration of the monitor. So go to the menu, and then you have the first option, which is picture. For brightness, I like to put it on 20. I tried several other settings. I found out that 20 is the best. And the most important setting here is the HDMI black level. You see how it is washed out now? Before I discovered this setting, I wanted to return the monitor because it was displaying the black as like a light gray and the colors were washed out. And I really didn't like the display of the monitor. But once I discovered this setting and I put it on low, it changed everything. So I advise you to put it on low. For gaming mode, it's a gimmick in my opinion because it only adjusts the brightness. But the most important one is the response time for gaming. So put it on fastest, and this is how you get good gaming on this monitor. Now we have also the PIP and picture by picture. You can set it up to display two inputs at the same time. Then you have the on-screen display menu if you want to change it. Then you have the system. In the system, you have FreeSync, and this is if you have an AMD GPU, which is not my case here. And for Echo Saving Plus, I like to put it on auto. Just a note here, if you put Echo Saving Plus on auto, the brightness will not be accessible anymore. So adjust the brightness before and then put the Echo Saving Plus on auto. Then you have the Off Timer Plus, PC AV mode, if you have something else than the PC which is connected, which is not my case. Then you have the display port version in case you have an older GPU, and the source detection, which I kept it on auto. And you have the other settings, the key repeat time, and you have also the power LED on. This is the LED on the bottom of the screen if you like it to be on all the time or only on standby. And you have also the reset all in case you want to just restart from scratch. You can put reset all and redo all the configurations. On the base of the monitor, you have a cable management system. It cannot accommodate too many cables, but nevertheless, it is very good. But I had also to support it with a fastener, so to have a clean installation and to be able to hide all the cables. For gaming, I tried the monitor with my favorite game, which is Asphalt 9. And I found out that the colors are vibrant, the display is really good, no stuttering, and there is no delay in the display, and I really liked it for gaming. Mind you, I'm not a big gamer, I just like to play Asphalt from time to time. But I think gamers will be happy with this monitor. The viewing angles on this Samsung UJ59 are really good. As you notice, the light barely changes when you view the monitor from an angle, even if it's a very wide angle. Even though this is an entry-level monitor in the 4K lineup of Samsung, Samsung didn't skimp on the quality of the display. They skimped maybe on other features like the height adjustment, the lack of USB hub, and the lack of speakers. But really, the quality of the display is unbeatable at this price range. So I'm very happy with my purchase. If you have comments or suggestions, or you want to share your experience with this monitor, please leave your comments in the comments section below. I want to thank you all for watching, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and share it. Until next time.